Mr. Allen here, let's math. We got the area of the sector of circle Q is 60 pi meters squared. So that shaded area there is 60 pi meters squared. If the measure of arc RT is 150 degrees, find the area and circumference of the circle. What do I need to find area and circumference? I need my radius. Radius is what I want right now, okay? That's the name of the game. I gotta figure that out. I don't know what it is. All right. But I do know the area of the sector, and I do know the arc measure. Perhaps I can jot down my universal proportion that I can set up to solve for some missing things, okay? So there's my proportion, right? Let's plug in what we know. I know that the arc measure is 150 degrees per the problem, right? Over the 360 degrees equals my sector area is 60 pi over my pi times the radius squared. And really, I don't need these degree markings here since those units would actually cancel out in the fraction. Okay, so now I think some reducing is in order here before we cross multiply. My pi's are gonna cancel out. I can reduce those down, and they're actually both divisible by 3, so this could become 5, and this divided by 3 would become 12. Now, we're a little bit more manageable. So I'm gonna have 5r squared when I cross multiply. 5r squared is equal to, and then it's going to be 12 times 60. Now, I can do 12 times 60 in my calculator, all right? But check this out. Are you ready? I'm going to divide by 5 while it's still separated. And I'm going to have r squared equals, well, 60 divided by 5, that'll reduce down to 12 there. And now I have 12 times 12, which is 144. And if you don't believe me, plug that bad boy into your calculator. Oh, wait. I waited. All right. Now, if I want to solve for r, because that's my goal, right? In green there, I want my radius. I'm going to square root on both sides. And now I'm going to get r equals 12. Okay. So there's my radius. That's our checkpoint. I want my area and circumference. So if I want my area equals pi times my radius squared. So the area is going to be, 12 squared is going to be 144. So I'll get 144 pi, and this is meters squared for area. So there's my area. How about my circumference? Circumference is 2 pi r, or pi times diameter. So I'm going to have, let's see here, 2 times 12 is going to give me 24 pi, and this is not unit squared. It's just going to be meters. There's my circumference. Have I finished the problem? I think I have. I got both the area and the circumference from that bad boy. This is why I like my proportion, because I can cross multiply. My first step is the same, right? Cross multiply and then solve for the missing variable. In this case, it was my radius. Whereas if I had a formula, I might have to do a lot of algebraic manipulation to get to that radius. So I like the proportion, cross multiply, starts the same every single time. And now we feeling fine. Out.